Can we start, madam?
Yes, Raja.
Yeah. And hearty welcome to the webinar today. And the theme and the topic is healthy aging during COVID-19 pandemic. And I welcome Dr. Ritu Rana, Mission Head, Health Help Age India, New Delhi. And I also welcome Professor P.T. Shukumar, MD, Professor of Psychiatry and Senior Consultant in Geriatric Clinic and Services, NIMHANS, Bangalore. And I would like to welcome Dr. A. Tirumurthy. Tirumurthy, sir, is expected to come. And also welcome Dr. Sojan Anthony, PhD Associate Professor, Department of Psychiatric Social Work, NIMHANS, Bangalore. And Dr. Shivshankar Reddy. Dr. Shivshankar Reddy is also not there. And they may be just now, sir, has joined Dr. Shivshankar Reddy Garu. And senior Mr. Reddy is MD and DM, Senior Residents Geriatric Clinic and Services, NIMHANS, Bangalore. And I also welcome all the senior citizens from Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Karnataka for this webinar as attendees. And also grateful to our Srimati Krupa Swaruparani, District Welfare Officer, and Medchel Malkajiri, District Hyderabad. And similarly to ABD Narayan Rao Garu, he is Assistant Director, Krishna District Welfare. Differently abled and senior citizens, government of Andhra Pradesh. And so all I welcome to this program. And as we know that the ongoing corona pandemic, more than 5 months, forcing all the human beings to suffer a lot, even before the ever before the history, it brought about unprecedented fear and uncertainty among the all, but particularly in the senior citizens, because of age factor, low immunity to fight against diseases, infections, various, and sometimes with the chronic diseases. And we have been getting so many calls to our HelpAge Elders Helpline, which has been operational in Hyderabad, Guntur, and Warangal, and also Eluru. And most of them are inquiring about their anguish about transport, fear and coming out, fear of coming out, and fear of COVID attack and no support. So in this connection, I would like to request Dr. Ritu Rana Madam to give you an opening. So I request Madam to give opening address.
Thank you, Rata. And I welcome, on behalf of HelpAge India, I welcome all the esteemed panelists and the participants for this webinar to discuss on the issues of mental health and well-being of the older population. So as I'll inform you that I have been working with HelpAge India as a mission head healthcare. And HelpAge India is an organization which works and care for the cause and work for the cause and care for the elderly. So globally, we see that the population is aging rapidly. And if we take India's scenario, today we are sitting at 1.38 billion population. And if 10% of that is taken as an older population above 60 years, so we are about 13.8 crore population, nearly 14 crore population, which is above the age of 60 years. So we have a huge population, and we are rapidly going towards the aging country. Mental health and well-being is as important as the age of the elderly and the above the 60 years as at any time of life. And if we see the statistics, about 6.6% of the disability of the elder population above the 60 years is because of the mental and neurological disorder. 15% of the population in this group are affected by the mental and neurological disorders globally. But what is unfortunate is that mental health conditions are usually unidentified, and a stigma around these conditions also make people reluctant to seek any help. So they won't go for any help for the mental health condition. And during the corona and this COVID pandemic, the issues of mental health has actually aggravated. Fear, anxiety, the fear of uncertainty, these are common things which are coming up during this uncertainty period. And more commonly in the elderly population, because they have been staying at home. We also recommended them to stay at home. But this is now for 6 months. And you never know that how long it will take to stay at home. So this has aggravated the problem. Helpage India has actually done a survey during the time in June, where we found that 61% of the population, elderly population, they feel isolated and disconnected, staying at home for a long. This disconnect has increased, has aggravated a fear of anxiety, mild to moderate depressions in this population. We also know that elderly and this population over the age, our senior people, are important part of our society. We can take a lot of experience and knowledge from them to protect them for this well-being and to make them healthy and aging well. We also need to contribute as an individual, as a society, as a family. We need to spend more and more time with them, engage them in certain activities, engage in their household activities, teach them a digital thing, because at a time now, the digital inclusion is very important. And where the families are not living together, there are many places, younger power generation has moved out from the place to other places, to other cities and to other countries. And the connection with the family is through mobile phone. Video conferencing is one of the way where they can connect it. So how to use that? That is the thing. How to use the digital mobile app to make your payments, to make your banking services. So this all can be taught by the family members to the elderly, to the older people, our grandchildren. Grandchildren can teach the grandparents, and grandparents can teach their learnings, their experiences to the grandchildren. So this intergenerational bonding will also make them feeling like they are together in this time of pandemic. So the population, the elderly population, the silver lining population, they'll feel that somebody and the family members of society is with them. So with all these kind of interventions, which can be done at an individual level, at the society level, the family level, we can actually help them to live active and healthy aging, and their mental well-being can be protected. So with my these words, I'm not taking a lot of time, and I'll open the deliberations, because I would like to hear from the esteemed speakers on the issues, how we can take care of the mental well-being of the elderly during this COVID time and beyond this COVID time. Thank you all. Raza, you are muted.
Yeah, sorry. And now Professor P.T. Shivakumar, M.D. He is a professor, psychiatric and senior consultant in geriatric clinic services, NIMHANS, Bangalore. And sir is giving his keynote address on health aging. Before that, I just wanted to a small biodata. Dr. P.T. Shivakumar, M.D. is a professor of psychiatry and specialized in geriatric mental health. He has been principal investigator for multiple research projects which attempt to understand aging and mental health. He collaborates with the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, various state governments and international funding organizations for funding strategic to promote healthy aging. He has more than 15 years experience in NIMHANS. So I request Professor Preeti Shivakumar, sir.
Yeah. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Yeah. So good morning, everybody.
Yeah.
I think at the outset, I would like to thank HelpAge India for taking this initiative. Mr. Raza and Dr. Rituruna and the team, I think thanks for collaborating with NIMHANS and then kind of giving this opportunity to interact with you all. I think Dr. Rituruna has given a good introduction as to what is happening this COVID. I will spend in the next few minutes talking about healthy aging, say the context of COVID pandemic and the challenges for healthy aging is something which we need to face. I think that is the theme for this year's International Day of Older Persons also, which is coming on 1st October 2020. I think organizations like HelpAge has done a tremendous amount of work during this COVID pandemic. And when we talk of elderly as a service beneficiary, we also need to acknowledge the role of many senior citizens who are putting their say life at risk and then being a frontline volunteers also. Because if you take medical field, many of the doctors are above 60 years and then they're actually leading the team and leading the initiative, contributing to the welfare of the public in general. And there are many other senior citizens who are contributing in their own way. And many of our leaders are above 60 and they are putting their life at risk. If you've seen, many of the people, prominent faces in the country have themselves kind of got challenged with COVID, but they have been putting their life at risk and then contributing to the nation in this hour of crisis. That is something which we need to know. And when we talk of healthy aging, this is also something like having a lot of resilience, optimism, and then kind of managing the adversities and then any challenges that is thrown. Age is just a number. It is not just elderly will not be able to face. They are vulnerable. But at the same time, it is not something like uniform for everybody. There are elderly who are in the best of their health and then they are able to contribute and lead the nation. Moving on, I think we need to understand what is healthy aging. Healthy aging is not just about maintaining good health. It is actually the process of developing and maintaining the functional ability. What do we say about functional ability? How the person is able to function and enable that enables the well-being in older age. The two key important aspects is functional ability and well-being. That's where the mental health is become integral part of the health as well as the concept of healthy aging. When we say functional ability, it is determined by what is the intrinsic capacity. When we say intrinsic capacity, it is both physical as well as mental capacity. That's what it plays a big role in the functional ability. But even in people who have compromised capacity, there can be a way to maintain functional ability if the environment is supportive. It is always an interaction of the intrinsic capacity and the environment. So when it comes to disability, when it comes to functional issues, the environment is not just a physical environment. It is about the social environment, policy environment, how the support structures are there. Okay, all these things matters in how a person with a physical challenge or a mental challenge is able to function. So that is where, if you see this graph, the intrinsic capacity may be declining with the biological age. When the age increases, there is a natural wear and tear of the biological process that happens in the body as well as the mind. There is, to some extent, there is a declining abilities are there, but the functional ability need not go down the trajectory completely. It can be maintained by the role of environment and the support systems. This is the concept of the World Health Organization, and it is depicted in the World Report on Aging and Health in 2015. And one needs to understand this. Okay. Now, there is a public health framework for healthy aging. As I told, healthy aging is not only for people who are in the best of their health. who are having a very good healthy or what we call a successful aging. Healthy aging applies to everybody. It is universal. So even if somebody who is having a significant disability, we talk about healthy aging because at that level of disability, one can maintain the better functioning. They can have a dignified life. So that is important. So if you see this cartoon, there are three kind of categories where we say the first category is people who have high and stable capacity. These are people who are doing the, even in elderly age, they are maintaining well. They are having good health. There is a third spectrum where people who are having significant loss of capacity. The in-between group is actually having a declining capacity. So if you can divide the entire population into these three groups. So the nature of intervention, the approach and the role of health services and the supportive environment varies according to their needs. When we talk of the people who are doing well, the goal is prevention. The goal is how do we maintain, how do we identify, make early diagnosis and then prevent some of the chronic conditions and then promote capacity enhancing behaviors. Something like yoga or physical activity or a cognitive activity can actually maintain your healthy aging to some to a large extent. When we come to declining capacity, that's where the role of health services becomes more and more. So here we treat people with diabetes, hypertension, depression, people with other psychiatric illnesses, okay, so anxiety. So the attempt is to reverse or slow decline in capacity. Somebody who's having a mild cognitive impairment, you might be able to correct the nutritional impairment and then you can actually change. So some amount of support capacity to enhance behaviors, like that is the role of some prompts, the role of some assistances can actually be helpful. The last bit of the last component where people who have already lost capacity, like those who have physical disability or mental disability, like dementia. Even then, we can actually manage these conditions and ensure a dignified late life. I think many of us can support them by the family members, the organizations, old age homes, residential care institutions, home care services, all or the change in the attitude, how we can include them in our day-to-day lives, how we can remove the barriers for their participation, how we can compensate for loss of capacity, all those things. I think this is the segment where we have a lot to improve. I think many of the developed countries have made facilities in which even somebody with functional impairment or disability can actually participate in a better manner. But in developing countries like India, there are lots of barriers, both physical barriers as well as attitudinal barriers and societal barriers. And the support services are not adequate. So we need to work on improving these things. I think this is an area where HelpAge and organizations like NIMHANS can collaborate and do a lot of things. And it needs an attitudinal change in the public. I think today's effort is also to look at these people. The moment you have a stroke or you have a cognitive problem, we should not think in a very pessimistic manner. We should not think that, okay, we just have to support them only to take care of their basic amenities. We need to see how we can enhance their functioning, how we can make their life in a dignified manner and support them. So the vision of World Health Organization is to a world where everyone can live a long and healthy life, which is a very idealistic kind of a vision. So there are many policies and programs which have come right from 1990s onwards, the Madrid Plan of Action of Aging. And now, actually, we have last few years, there was a strategic plan, the Global Strategy and Action Plan of Aging and Health, where there are five main objectives. The first is to every country should commit that healthy aging is an important objective. And this commitment should come from the highest level to the lowest level. Only when the commitment is there, we can expect action. This is where our governments have signed the commitments, but it is not just a letter. It should be followed in the spirit. I think organizations like us, we have to advocate for them to implement these objectives. I think the citizens' voice is very, very important in making sure that this commitment is followed. Already our governments have committed to this cause, and we need to make sure that these are implemented in the real spirit. And the second aspect is about developing age-friendly environments. Any environment, it should be disabled or age-friendly. It should be accessible for all. It should not be only for the younger people. When a public facility is designed, they should know that an elderly person also can access that. There should be a ramp. There should be access to a lift. All those things are very, very important things, which is a right. It is not a charity. When people have to think of people who will have challenges, and these things are taken as a right. It is not something like a charity. And when we talk of health systems, the health systems need to align for older population. What do we say aligning health systems for older population? It should be elderly friendly, in the sense that the waiting time should be less. It should be easily accessible for them. The way how they are handled, for example, the kind of medicines what is available, the support systems what is available, they should get easily the beds. It should be affordable for them. It should be accessible for them. All those things are important. These are actually mandated by laws, the legal provisions which are there, like Maintenance Act, Maintenance and Welfare of Parents and Senior Citizens Act 2007, which actually mandates these things. And then there should also be support system. Like, we wish that everybody is independent. We wish that everybody is taken care of by the families. But unfortunately, there are people who cannot be taken care of, or who cannot be supported, or who have less support system, who needs more support. So there is a need to develop long-term care systems which provide support at home, community, or institutions. If you take a country like the Scandinavian countries or European countries, these systems are well developed. They have people going to multiple times in a elderly person living alone, and then providing their basic assistance even up to 5 to 6 times a day. Here, these services are available in a very limited manner, but it is very costly. It is not affordable for a common man. It is not affordable for the most needy people. That is where I think we need to advocate, and then we need to improve the services. Now, we are in the midst of a launching of a decade of healthy aging. They have, because the challenges related to aging is increasing, United Nations and World Health Organization has considered 2020-30 as a decade of healthy aging. That is the importance. It is going to be launched on 1st October 2020. And the main, say, the action which is targeted during this decade is to change how we think, feel, and act towards aging. Our mindset should change. It is not just we say in words, but it is just how we think, feel, and act. It is not no longer a kind of a charity. It is a right. Okay, so we need to change our attitude towards aging. Then we should develop the communities which are which foster the abilities of older people, because age is just a number. Beyond 60, people still have a lot of abilities. They should be able to participate. They should be productive. They should be able to sit in wherever they are. They should be equally contributing to the society and themselves, which itself is a very important factor for healthy aging. And what we say as a person-centered, integrated care and primary health services responsive to older people. This is where the concept of health and wellness centers, Ayushman Bharat initiative which the government is doing, all these things are, in a sense, to promote these aspects. Universal health coverage, all these things are linked to these things. We have a target of something called a sustainable development goals, where there are 17 targets which are supposed to be met by all the countries in 2030, of which many of the targets are relevant for older adults. And without providing services to them, these targets cannot be met. And it is a target which nobody should be left out. That is the whole purpose of the sustainable development goals. And services to elderly is very, very important in these aspects. And provision to long-term care, which I already spoke about, which is again a very emerging kind of field, which is not well developed. Recently, there was I should really mention that HelpAge India is one of the organizations which had actually the previous CEO, Mr. Matthew Cherian, he had actually was one of the amicus curiae in this public interest litigation, which was there in Supreme Court, which talked about the rights of elderly people, and they said it is a statutory and fundamental right to provide good support systems, healthcare, long-term care systems. So there is a lot of directions which have come from the government of from the Supreme Court to the government, state governments, as well as the central government. But we need to follow it up and then see these things are actually implemented in a realistic manner. And I think this is also, and we need to acknowledge the services of HelpAge India in this important contribution, where they were the services of Mr. Matthew Cherian was taken as an amicus curiae. Now, when we talk of age-friendly community, the concept of World Health Organization talks about outer space, how it should be friendly, it should be accessible. Transportation systems means availability of say road transport or accessibility in the, when you go by rail or any modes of transport. And the last mile connectivity, which should be usable for elderly, physically disabled should be able to board the buses or the transport system safely, and then it should be wheelchair friendly. All these aspects are very important. Housing. We see many elderly who are in the second floor, third floor without lift. They have to be lifted by somebody to come in stairs. Many of the challenges are there in the lower middle class and middle class. And some of the old buildings of 3-4s, which were designed earlier, including some in our Niman's campus and our quarters, were not designed with these facilities, because the old buildings will not have ramp or lift. But many of the senior citizens who live there will have a lot of challenges. But henceforth, when it is kind of designed, it should be convenient for elderly. And social participation. We are in the corona time, where COVID times, where socialization is becoming a big challenge. Technology, as Dr. Ritu told, technology can be helpful. The way we are meeting today, it is very, very helpful to maintain the social connectivity and social inclusion. And volunteering is another important aspect where senior citizens can play a big role. Recently, we had a drive of actually mobilizing volunteers for our programs for lay counseling. Nearly 250 individuals actually registered with us to provide volunteering services for lay counseling. And many of them were elderly. They were already providing a lot of services in many NGOs. Because of COVID, they are actually not able to contribute physically, but they are willing to contribute sitting in their home through telecounseling. So this is an opportunity where I will also take to invite people to reach out to us. We will also reach out to you. I think we all can join together, and volunteering can help the society, can help you also. It is important for your own well-being by sending time productively. Your healthy aging, you can contribute to your healthy aging. And I think some of the initiatives way back, many years back, HelpAge and Niman's came together to start something called as Walking Plus programs in public park. My colleague, Dr. Girish, was a key person behind this. And this movement actually caught up in Bangalore. In multiple public parks, we see these equipments where the elderly can come and do physical activity. What started as a simple initiative actually got the attention of public representatives in the civic agencies, and it has got extended to all the parks in Bangalore. So I think this is probably HelpAge might have taken this to other places also. I think this is one of the initiatives where we had collaborated with HelpAge. I think many years back, I think it was in 2003 or 4, something like that, or 2006 or something like that. Niman's has actually started what is a state resource center for senior citizens with the government of Karnataka, and it has developed a lot of networking with many NGOs and organizations to provide services for senior citizens, and a lot of advocacy initiatives we have been doing. We also, this center got inaugurated a few years back by the minister, and we also are collaborating actively with the Legal Services Authority in Karnataka, and then we launched a campaign called Age Friendly Karnataka, where we are networking with various senior citizen forums, old age homes, educational institutions, corporate organizations to promote awareness, to provide free legal services clinic. We have started a clinic in the Niman's campus and also do a lot of outreach initiatives and a lot of awareness initiatives to promote awareness about Maintenance Act for senior citizens. So many such programs were conducted in the last few years. So legal services camp, which include medical camp and various facilities, have been conducted. One of the old age homes, Gandhi Old Age Home, which we visited, one of the first old age homes where we did a camp and awareness program. Now, with collaboration with HelpAge, now again, we are talking of a program for mental health well-being, a more systematic activity is being planned and which we are going to roll out in one of the old age homes in Bangalore, as well as maybe this will be extended to many other centers. And this age-friendly Karnataka initiative, which we launched with the Supreme Court, with the Chief Justice of Karnataka, currently is in Supreme Court of India. So this is an initiative of the Government of Karnataka and the Legal Service Authority and NIMHANS, which promotes this age-friendly community in Karnataka. This had to be taken into a larger forum. I think we invite HelpAge India also to collaborate with us to take this into a national level initiative. And many interactive programs and training programs have been conducted. And online programs, I think senior citizens from across the country can link online. And then we are training on wellness of health and wellness of senior citizens. We are training volunteers. These things can be helpful. This is a new initiative which we are going to launch this October. We have termed this as Vayo Manasa Sanjeevani, which is an initiative to promote mental health and well-being of older adults, where one of the main aspects is about promoting awareness on aging and mental health. We're going to launch a series of webinars and also which is going to be a continuous program where various aspects about aging and mental health will be discussed through webinars and training of lay counselors. So I think the kind of scale of the problem what we are having, many would not require, it would not be possible for professionals to address the need. And we require a lot of lay counselors to be trained. And then actually many of the problems, minor problems, can be handled by them. And many of the senior citizens can become lay counselors themselves, having a lot of wisdom, a lot of experience with them. They can actually contribute by volunteering. And we are also training caregivers who are providing home care assistance 24/7 to elderly, training them on mental health care. So we have around 800 caregivers registered with us now. We are initiating the online training for them. And these are some things which can promote the healthy aging and well-being of older adults. And we also are planning telecounseling interventions, considering the COVID challenges, and old age home psychosocial interventions in partnership with HelpAge as well as with other organizations. Integrative medicine. I think our culture has a lot of traditional medicines like Ayurveda, yoga. These things can play a big role in healthy aging. We have been doing a lot of research on yoga applications, and recently we are starting, we have started a center for integrative medicine, which has yoga and Ayurveda. And this initiative is also kind of an effort to promote integrative medicine for healthy aging, along with allopathic medicines. So along with mental health issues management. And telepsychiatry, where telecounseling, telepsychotherapy, telepsychiatric consultations can actually take mental health care to the nook and corners of the country, where many of the elderly will not be having access easily to psychiatrists or mental health professionals. So this is something which we are launching it in a big way. We're already doing it. And NIMHANS is developing a center for aging and mental health with all these facilities, which can actually promote mental health and well-being. And we are also developing systems for support, long-term care systems for dementia care also, which we need a lot of support from NGOs and organizations and from the public. And we need to make a lot of innovations, how healthy aging can be promoted to Indian context. That is where a technology development, which can be adapted for Indian settings, is required. So with all these things, what is very important is multi-stakeholder collaborations. This is an initiative which cannot be done by a single organization. All of us have to come together. I think today's program, we see HelpAge and NIMHANS coming together. And it is not only with health, it is about various departments like labor, transport, say the civic agencies like corporations, police, legal system. Everything has a stake for elderly. So all these stakeholders have to collaborate and then have a sustained action to promote healthy aging. We believe this decade of action of healthy aging will contribute to this cause, and we will come together to promote this concept of age-friendly community and age-friendly health systems. We need to focus on people who are most needy segment. The people, the initiative should be inclusive. There is always a risk when we talk about tele initiatives or technology oriented initiatives, we can exclude people, a large segment of population who don't have access to all these systems. But how do we overcome this challenge? Once the COVID situation comes down, we need to have grassroots level volunteers like paralegal volunteers or HelpAge or NGO volunteers to support these activities at a population level. And that's where we can cover these population, which are the most neglected and most vulnerable segment of the population. So with this, I would like to conclude. I think we have a big mission ahead of us, and this decade of initiatives, what we want to talk about is something which I think today's panel, all learned people would also discuss, and we will come together to achieve this task. Thank you for the opportunity. I think our team would be there. The session, look forward to suggestions, and we invite all the participants as well as other organizations to come forward and collaborate and then take this mission forward.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Shivakumar, sir. And really, it is a very good collaboration with NIMHANS and HelpAge in promoting age-friendly, not only in Karnataka, to the grassroots levels of the people, as you said. And also, this your sustainable development goals of 17. And as you said, we work together and in promoting healthy aging, and particularly to the needy elders of the agriculture and grassroots people. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Now I request Dr. A. Thirumurthy, PhD. Before that, I just wanted to tell him, sir is a professor and former head department of psychiatric social work, NIMHANS, Bangalore. And today, sir is going to talk on social aspect of aging. So Dr. Thirumurthy is a PhD professor of psychiatric social work and former head department of psychiatric social work at NIMHANS. And he has 15 years of experience in geriatric mental health. He guides and guided more than 10 PhDs in this area. His core area of research are palliative care and psychological care for elderly. Sir, your valuable message to our senior citizens is going to be a great advantage. So I request you to give your ideas on this. I think you are in mood, sir. Thirumurthy, sir, you are just unmute yourself. Yeah, now okay.
Very good morning to all of you. Is it audible to you, sir?
Yeah, perfect.
Very good morning, and it's a great opportunity for all of us to assemble here to help the elderly for the common cause. We understand that COVID-19 has become a major challenge, not only for the professionals, but also to the entire society. I am sure that this challenge we will be able to achieve, and we will be able to come out with a concrete solution to help this vulnerable population. And we know that the elderly who are having different kinds of comorbidity, different kinds of illness already, which they are having, it may be a physical problem or psychological problem or any kind of problems, adding these situations, it becomes more vulnerable. It is not because of aging process alone, it is because of various other opportunity challenges. See, here the every attempt of us in terms of collaborating or networking or any kind of programs which aims at creating or providing a or helping them in a healthy aging process. The healthy aging process is to make them physical well-being, psychological well-being, emotional well-being, and social well-being. These are the basic well-being are aimed at in every programs. So we know that different kinds of challenges due to their aging process itself, and COVID created a kind of challenges for them and the human being and the entire society, government, all those things. See, we often hear that the major concerns which is striking, and it's a kind of social issue that we often hear that they are all increased risk for death. So the increase in risk for death is in the context of the aging. The healthy aging, the person who is very healthy also vulnerable, or already the person who has been having different comorbidities are more vulnerable. So the context of aging, it becomes a major challenge for all of us to look at. But it created a kind of change in the way they were doing it. For example, some kind of particular activities are engaged in some social activities or social kind of meeting the friends or daily routines or any kind of home-based assignments, office assignment, which they were not able to do right now. So that becomes a kind of difficult or differences for them in managing that. So the diet is another kind of challenge where the initial phase of COVID kind of occurrence, they were having lots of difficulty, but now it become very easy because of various kind of restriction is lifted upon. So the diet, whatever the situation is there, elderly needs to be provided healthy and nutritious diet. Because the family dynamics, one of the major areas where the all members, the COVID created a situation such that now the entire family are united or sometimes is disintegrated. The two aspects has happened. The family, when united, the different kinds of attitude, the different kinds of age, the different kinds of their behavior, all of them affecting. We are trying to make them understand in terms of helping them, respecting them, and hand-holding them. These are the major social kind of things which we are. See, any event will create a kind of impact. It may be a physical impact, or it may be a psychological impact, or it may be a social impact. But the common kind of impact due to the isolation of elderly is anxiety, depression, stress, and social ideations. And restlessness, we know that as the process of aging, the elderly will experience some kind of sleep disturbances. It is a natural kind of thing. But we need to help them, engage them, entertain them, cope with different kinds of physical problems, address them, and engage them in proper manner by which they may be able to, their sleep pattern or quality of sleep may be improved. See, we need to consider a particular focus on to how to help persons with the elderly with the dementia. So these are the special populations who are much vulnerable compared to the normal individual. A normal elderly who may be having a kind of socialization, who may be having a support, who may be having networking, who may be having some kind of ability to do that. What Dr. P.T. Sivakumar is doing, by it is not that because of aging they may not be able to do it. There are healthy individuals, still they are able to perform. But people like persons with dementia, already they are having some kind of cognitive deficits, cognitive decline. So because of which they may not be able to perform as like any other normal aged persons. So we need to help them, and you need to address the social kind of issues related to the person who is living single and lost their spouse. Because of the loss, because of the living alone or staying away from the family members, it becomes a kind of insecure feeling, inferiority complex. They may not be able to think positively. So the person who is having homeless is another major challenge for us. And the marginalized persons like migration, all those things. What as an agency, governmental or non-governmental agency, can focus, extend the kind of supportive counseling, relaxation training, facilitating the support. And the specific interventions like crisis management, how to help them during the crisis. The crisis may be an immediate or it may be an ongoing. As a social activist, as a professionals, as a counselors, we need to help them. See, when somebody's lost, somebody has lost their family members, they will experience a kind of grief, intense emotions associated with the loss. We need to address. If you don't address properly, then it will become a complicated grief or complicated mental health problems in the later stage. So you need to identify and address what kind of experiences due to loss an elderly is facing. Sometimes, yes, it's a simple kind of thing that the families got away from them or living away from them. The anticipatory anxiety, what is happening to them, what is going to happen to them, and I am here, how well they are they taking care of them, any challenges for them. So all those things they will be experiencing at home, we need to help them. So as nowadays there are several services which we are offering to help them. Telephonic counseling, where Dr. P.T. Sivakumar is pointed out that you can contact them, inquire about them, whether they are taking medicines, whether they are following up the doctor or going to the hospital, or whether they get adequate facilities from the hospital or any crisis management, all those things are available. There are some support groups also available. We are in NIMHANS, we are conducting some of the support groups for elderly or caregivers in order to help them understand and provide effective care services. As they keep giving care to the elderly, they become kind of depressed. They may not be able to cope up with, they may not be able to deal better way. So some kind of skill building program also we are helping them learn during this online support program. And due to this, there are some family will have small problems or major problems. And whatever the problems, when you see that there is a differences in the attitude, differences in the behavior, differences in the entire family, you can probably evaluate them and provide appropriate solutions. See, we understand that every guidelines we need to follow. For example, the government guidelines to safety is use of sanitation, wearing masks, keeping social distance, all those things. Similarly, World Health Organization also has given its guidelines to ensure safety for elderly, provide support for elderly. This adequate support will strengthen their ability to function, prevent physical and mental illness among elderly. See, when you extend social support, when you extend love and care, when you give compassionate, when you show empathy, when you transform, when you accommodate them, all these psychological well-being makes them kind of happiness. See, ultimately, whatever the program you do is the promotion of mental health well-being, the emotional well-being, which connects very well to express love and affection to them. In turn, they will return the same way what we expect. See, what is the common basic needs for anybody? Similarly, the elderly needs to be provided healthy, nutritious, adequate food, shelter, whatever the infrastructure one is living with, little space for them, and make sure that whether they are taking proper medications, whether they are complying with the doctors, are they happy with that, or any follow-up is missing, all those things you need to. And every need, there is a monetary aspect is involved. You make sure that their provisions, their needs are met with sufficient monetary resources. So to maintain a healthy lifestyle, as we know that there are several activities they can engage in. For example, creative activities, writing. There are some of the individual elderly will be very skilled. They may write very well story about the past. They may create some kind of thing, engaging in some kind of innovative activities. For example, embroidery or drawing or singing. You engage them to make them happy. See, ultimately, we are trying to instill a kind of positive attitude with them. So try to connect with nowadays, the physical distance we need to maintain, we are not allowing them to expose outside. So the digital platform is very much available. They can talk to them over the phone. They can share their social medias. They can contact them through Facebook or WhatsApp. So multiple social medias by which they can still connect and share their experiences. They can continue to give the care. They can continue to take the care also. So we told that how the physical distancing, see, you need to very clearly make them how physical distance is important. At the same time, physical distance doesn't mean that one has to get away from them. The physical distance to get infection, to prevent the infection from getting whatever the kind of current situations, this is in the context of COVID. But at the same time, the psychological proximity you can maintain, you can call them, you can talk to them, you can share them, you can easily connect with them and speak to them whatever the way. So you can make them and try to provide, you can so that is expressed in the form of empathy. Empathy is a kind of a transformation of your own emotional kind of thing to other persons, which make individual that there is a trustworthy person whom they can rely upon. So whenever we provide any kind of services or wherever the occasion or whatever the occasions, you try to make them with soft kind of thing. See, when you speak, sometimes your gesture, you may be a good person to help, or your gesture or physical appearance, the kind of tone, tempo you maintain and address them, it will make them kind of scary or unhappy about the communication that you have. So the kind of emotional communication becomes a very, very important role in making them understand and feel that the sense of satisfaction through your own help. So several rituals, you can encourage them as a social situation. They can pray collectively, keeping social distance at home itself. They can do individual yoga, meditations, or listen to the music. Always, whenever there is such kind of difficult situations or arises, if you feel that, if you are seeing that somebody needs to be helped immediately, there are crisis intervention helpline at district hospital, taluk hospitals, and NGOs, they are offering very good services. You can connect with the nearby NGOs, and through which they can be helped immediately. So always, again, the psychological components of help them, be with them, share with them, reassure them that for every crisis there is a solution. Every problem will get rid of with the correct solution. So it is a temporary kind of crisis. for which we are reacting it, and our aim is to help make them satisfied and continue to provide support. Thank you one and all for giving this wonderful opportunity.
Thank you, Dr. Tirumurthy sir, and thank you for your suggestion for showing empathy towards the elders, and also the manage then how to spend time with the family, with the elderly people at home, and also the role of the society. And you also mentioned how small problems will leads to a major problem and make elderly worry about this. And the present context, people are worried about anxiety, and they are isolated, and they are fear of death or fear of effect of the COVID. So under this situation, how the family members can help? And thank you, sir. Thank you very much. And in this crisis situation, and the role of the family as well as NGOs. Now I request Mr. Sojan Anthony, PhD, is an associate professor, Department of Psychiatric Social Work, NIMHANS, Bangalore. Dr. Sojan Anthony is an associate professor in Department of Social Work, and he is a social work consultant of Geriatric and Adult Mental Health team of NIMHANS. He collaborates with the National Institute of Social Defense for promoting healthy aging, and he is also known trainer for stress management program and prevention of substance abuse among elderly. So I request Mr. Sojan to give his presentation.
Thank you, Muhammad Razak sir, for inviting us to this program. We thank HelpAge India for hosting us. Our entire team is here, and some more team are also available, but we have not included because of time limitation. I'm very happy to tell that how we can manage stress among elderly. As you know that, how do we manage our stress? If we have enough resources to manage our day-to-day needs, we are not under stress. If we do not have enough resources to manage our day-to-day needs, we are under stress. It may look very simple definition, but in many times we emotionally or we know cognitively struggle to solve problems because of limited resources. I just wanted to know, my friend Dr. Sivasankar Reddy is here already. So he also will be speaking in detail about various brain related aspects. So elderly, they experience both physical and mental changes. Many times people in the society do not understand these kind of changes, what happens in the brain. And they misunderstand the behavior of elderly. They socially isolate elderly. They lose opportunity in the mainstream of the society. One thing what Dr. P.T. Shivakumar sir has mentioned is participating in social activities, it is not a favor for elderly. It is their right. It is participation in family affairs or in social affairs. It is their right. It is not a favor from society. Why I'm telling, just take case of any senior citizen who is above the age of 60 years. He might have spent his 40 years for building our nation, paying taxes for our country, and sacrificed his entire life for his children and grandchildren. After taking all kind of services from them, we cannot deny their opportunities. Like children, you know, in India, we have Anganawadis for children. We have child care schemes for children. We have district level child care justice system in India. What about elderly? Many of the elderly are victims of elder abuse. I'm very sorry to tell, HelpAge India has done an extensive survey where we all came to know that many senior citizens are victims of their family members' deeds. So elderly, they are denied their basic human rights. Elderly people are denied the basic medical care. forget about human rights and medical care. Many elderly people are denied the food, shelter, and space. So unfortunate. We all need to join hands together and to support. What exactly elderly people they need? We need to express the gratitude. We need to respect them. We need to give a social space for them in the family to lead a life with dignity. Many times we forget them. They are also human beings. They also have their own emotions. They also have their own thoughts. They also have their own feelings. We forget to respect them. We forget to involve them. We exclude them. It is so unfortunate to tell that in many, many communities, they extract the entire assets which is built by this elderly for their retirement. Many children, grandchildren, they take money, they take property, they take assets, and they discard the rights of elderly. I also seen that old age home. The amount of loneliness experienced by elderly living in community, the elderly living in old age home, we cannot justify. People say that it is because of structural changes in the family, migration, poverty, unemployment, underemployment. Whatever reasons, we do not have any right to deny the rights of elderly. That is the forum where we are working. I'm very sure that NIMHANS, as a National Institute of Mental Health and Neuroscience, is a leading organization which can help community to understand behavior and brain. Like why some elderly is very rigid, why some elderly is repeating certain questions, why elderly is, you know, be very sensitive, why some elderly is argue a lot, why some elderly do not get sleep, why elderly forget, why some elderly show more favoritism for some children compared to the other children. So all this kind of behavioral changes in aging, NIMHANS, as a national institute in the field of neuroscience, we will collaborate with HelpAge India across India for helping people to understand why elderly is different from youngsters in terms of learning, in terms of behavior, sometimes in terms of little rigid behavior. I know many elderly are not very rigid. Many elderly, they adapt, adjust, sacrifice for their children and grandchildren. So with these few words, let me conclude. I just wanted to tell people who are attending today's session as an elderly, five mantras for you to practice, stress management thing. This is your life, for don't forget. You have another 20 to 30 years. Now you may be at the age of 60. You have another 30 beautiful years are waiting for you. Please don't forget to enjoy the every moment. Please enjoy yourself. You are a citizen of India. You have full rights. Enjoy that. No, you are not going to die soon, okay? Many elderly are worrying whether we will die or not. Forget about that. When we die, we will die. But you have, imagine you have 30 beautiful years ahead. That is the first mantra. Believe always you have 30 more beautiful years. Even if you are at the age of 70, believe that you have another 30 years. Okay. So 30 years, 3 decades. You have enough time. People will tell who are around you. Anyway, you are an older person. You are what you are going to do. You are, nothing is there for you. You are already finished your life. No. Tell them, remind them. My life is not over. I am a sweet young old age person, but I have another 30 years to continue. So that's the first mantra. Second mantra is here and now. Don't worry about what happened in the past. Don't worry about what is going to happen in the future. Nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to change. You believe that here and now. If you are drinking a cup of tea, don't think about your children or grandchildren. Enjoy that tea powder. Enjoy that sugar in the tea. Enjoy the flavor of that tea. Forget about the rest of the world. So here and now, second mantra. Third mantra is thinking, so what? Sometimes our daughter-in-laws will say that because of you, we are suffering. Sometimes our son-in-laws will say that because of you, we are suffering. Sometimes when we fight with our grandchildren for television remote, they will say that because of you, we are not enjoying life. Forget about that. You ask yourself, so what? So what? Let them blame. It is my right to live with my children and grandchildren. At times when they are in bad mood, when they have physical issues, mental issues, they may shout, why should I worry? It is their brain problem. Think so what? Fourth problem is, you are the leader. You have 60 or 70 years of life experience. You know what is life. You are a leader. You are not a victim. You are a leader. So your experience can help your children, your grandchildren, and their family. Because why I'm telling, now we know we are in crisis. What exactly is helping us? Our culture is helping us to survive. Though I am a Christian, I strongly believe that in Indian mythology, we believe that do our duty, don't wait for results. A beautiful piece of counseling, which is written in Indian philosophy. Do our duty, don't wait for result, result will come. Similarly, you may have a lot of wisdoms which you use for surviving, which you use for protecting relationship. My dear young elderly friends, let us use this wisdom for our younger generation. For a small frustration, our youngsters are trying to end their life. See, you had hundreds of frustrations in life. You cross all those crises, you are surviving. So many youngsters need that diamond, that golden knowledge from you for them to survive. That's my fourth message. Fifth message is final mantra. Divide your life into 3 8-hour. First 8 hours spend only for sleep. Sleep is a very important medicine for your brain. So first 8 hours for sleep. In a 24 hours, make sure that 8 hours you will take time for sleep. Another 8 hours for your personal care, like, you know, your physical activities, your habits and all kind of things. Another 8 hours you should spend for social networking, social connection, something productive activity, volunteering. You join in HelpAge India as an volunteer. They need hundreds of volunteers to spread their beautiful messages for elderly. And like some forums are there to prevent loneliness among elderly. Join such beautiful forums or daycare facilities, and then ensure that you are productively engaged. So this dividing a day, 24 day hours day into 3 8-hour and engaging yourself is very important. My final message, sitting simply is more riskier than smoking. It means that if you sit simply without physical activity, your longevity or your health drastically will decline. So physical activity, social engagement are two tiers of your bike to proceed. So don't forget it. Physical activity and social engagement will help you to enjoy your another 30 years of beautiful life without much worries. Thank you so much, HelpAge, for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, Dr. Sojan Anthony. It is a very good how to overcome the stress management and how to handle this anxiety and overcome depression and how to burst the isolation. You have told with your 5 mantras, and I'm sure that all our senior citizens have noted all these points. And thank you once again. And now I request Dr. Shivashankar Reddy. And he's a senior resident and geriatric clinic and services of NIMHANS Bangalore. And Dr. Reddy is a senior resident in Department of Psychiatry at National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences. He completed MBBS from Karnool Medical College, Andhra Pradesh. He completed his MD in psychiatry at NIMHANS. And later he did postdoctoral fellowship and DM in geriatric psychiatry. He conducted many awareness programs on mental health issues at old age homes and senior citizens forums. He is involved in research activities related to mental health issues in older adults and dementia. So I request Dr. Shivashankar Reddy to give his presentation.
Hello, thank you, Andy, Mr. Rana, Mr. Mohammed Ra. And Dr. Mithur Rana garu for inviting me. I think majority of the audience are Telugu speaking people, I guess. So nenu Telugu ne maatladtanu. So I think my team also want me to talk in Telugu. So for the last 6 months, I think మనం ఒక లాస్ట్ 6 నెలలుగా మనం చూస్తున్నది ఏంటంటే ఫర్ జనరేషన్స్ మనం ఎప్పుడు చూడలేదు ఇలాంటి సిచ్యుయేషన్ సినారియోస్ ని మనం సొసైటీలో చూస్తున్నాం ఇప్పుడు. సో ఫర్ లాస్ట్ 50 ఇయర్స్ కూడా మీరు తీసుకుంటే కూడా వీఆర్ సీన్ ఫెమైన్స్ స్పెసిఫిక్ లోకల్ డిజాస్టర్స్ చూసాం తప్ప ఒక పాన్ ఇండియా ఒక డిజాస్టర్ ఒక ఎపిడెమిక్ ని మనం పాండమిక్ ని ఎప్పుడు చూడలేదు అనమాట. సో వయసు పడిన వాళ్ళు మెయిన్గా వృద్ధులు 60 ఏళ్ళు దాటిన వాళ్ళు ఇంకా పైబడిన వాళ్ళకి స్పెసిఫిక్ ఇష్యూస్ చాలా ఉంటాయి వాళ్ళకి. ఆల్రెడీ ఒక ఫ్యామిలీలో చూస్తే మనము పిల్లలు ఉంటారు, మధ్య వయసు వాళ్ళు ఉంటారు, పనిచేసే వాళ్ళు ఉంటారు, ఒక వృద్ధులు ఉంటారు అనమాట. మన ఇండియాలో ప్రస్తుతం 60% పైన ఫ్యామిలీస్లో ఒకరు లేదా ఇద్దరు 60 వయసు పడిన వాళ్ళు ఉన్నారు, 18 ఇయర్స్ బిలో వాళ్ళు కూడా ఉన్నారు. అంటే ఒక 3 జనరేషన్స్ ఉన్న వాళ్ళు ఒకే కుటుంబంలో ఉంటున్నారనమాట. వీళ్ళకి యూజువల్ ఇష్యూస్ ఏముంటాయంటే స్కూల్ పిల్లలు స్కూల్కి వెళ్తారు, మధ్య వయసు వాళ్ళు వర్క్ వెళ్తారు, ఎల్డర్లీ వాళ్ళు దే విల్ గో ఫర్ వాళ్ళు వాకింగ్ అనో లేకపోతే వాళ్ళ ఫ్రెండ్స్ కలవడం కోసమో వాళ్ళ టెంపుల్స్ అనో వాళ్ళ దినచర్య అలా ఉండేదన్నమాట. సో ఈ కోవిడ్ వల్ల ఏం జరిగిందంటే బేసికల్గా స్కూల్కి వెళ్ళే పిల్లలు స్కూల్ మానేశారు, ఆఫీస్కి వెళ్ళే మధ్య వయసు వాళ్ళు ఇంట్లో నుంచి వర్క్ చేయడం మొదలుపెట్టారు, వృద్ధులు ఇంట్లోనే మెజారిటీ ఆఫ్ ద టైం 90% టైం వాళ్ళు ఇంట్లోనే ఉండడం మొదలుపెట్టారు. ఇంకో విషయం ఏంటంటే 75% పైన ఈ మన 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 కంట్రీలో దే లివ్ ఇన్ ఏదో 2 రూమ్స్ ఆర్ లెస్ దాన్ 2 రూమ్స్. సో ఇన్ ఈ మెజర్స్లో సోషల్ ఐసోలేషన్ పాటించడం చాలా కష్టం, ఇట్స్ ఎ ఛాలెంజింగ్ టాస్క్ ఐ మీన్. సో ఈ మెజారిటీ టైం స్పెండ్ చేయడం వల్ల వాళ్ళు చెప్పుకోలేరు, ఈ పిల్లలు పెద్దవాళ్ళు దే కెన్ డిస్కస్, బట్ ఈ వృద్ధులు ఏంటంటే వాళ్ళలో వాళ్ళు బాధపడుతూ వాళ్ళు బయటికి చెప్పలేరు వాళ్ళ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్, వాళ్ళకి నీడ్స్ ఏంటో వాళ్ళు చెప్పలేరు, వాళ్ళ సోషల్ వెల్ఫేర్ మెజర్స్ వాళ్ళకి రీచ్ కావట్లేదు. వాళ్ళ మెడికల్ కేర్ అంటాం అంటే ఎమర్జెన్సీ కేర్ అవైలబుల్ ఉంది కానీ రొటీన్గా రెగ్యులర్ ఎసెన్షియల్ మెడికల్ కేర్ అనేది ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ టేకెన్ ఎ బ్యాక్ స్టెప్. ఇవన్నీ కూడా జరగడం లేదు. సో ఇవన్నీ కలిసినప్పుడు వాళ్ళ స్ట్రెస్ లెవెల్స్ విపరీతంగా పెరిగిపోయినాయి. ఈ స్ట్రెస్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ ఎలా ఉంటుందంటే ఈ స్ట్రెస్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ అనేది ఒకటి మెంటల్ హెల్త్ మీద ఉంటుంది, ఇంకొకటి ఫిజికల్ బాడీ మీద ఉంటుంది. సో ఇట్ ఆల్సో షో ఇన్ దట్ బిహేవియర్ ఆల్సో. సో బిహేవియర్ మీద ఎలా ఉంటుందంటే నిద్ర రాకపోవడం, నర్వస్గా ఫీల్ అవ్వడం, టెన్షన్ ఫీల్ అవ్వడము, బోర్డమ్ అనేది చాలా అసలు ఇట్ ఇస్ ద మేజర్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ ఫ్యూ మంత్స్. సో అస్తమానం ఏమీ తోచకపోవడము, ఏం చేయాలో తెలియకపోవడము, అన్సర్టెనిటీ అంటే అసలు ముందు ఏం జరుగుతుందో తెలియకపోవడము, వాళ్ళు ఎక్కడ ఉంటారో తెలియకపోవడము. సో ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్లో ల్యాప్సెస్ ఉండడం అంటే వాళ్ళకి వచ్చే ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ కూడా కంటిన్యూస్ మీడియా కవరేజ్ వల్ల చాలా తీవ్రమైన పరిస్థితులు ఉన్నాయి, బయట బయటకు వెళ్తే ఏం జరుగుతుందో తెలియదు, నేను మళ్ళీ వస్తానో తెలియదు అనుకోవడము. ఇంకా ఒంటరిగా ఉన్న వాళ్ళైతే ఒకవేళ ఏమో జరుగుతే వాళ్ళకి వేరే వాళ్ళు వచ్చి చూడలేరేమో ఇంకెప్పటికి అనేది ఆ భయం ఉండడము, హాస్పిటల్కి వెళ్తే ఇంక అక్కడే చనిపోతే మళ్ళీ అసలు ఫ్యూనరల్ కూడా ఎవరు రారేమో అన్నట్టు ఆ భయం, అంటే అంత్యక్రియలు కూడా ఎవరు చేయలేరేమో అన్నంత భయం ఉండడము. సో ఇవన్నీ మీడియా ప్రొజెక్షన్ కూడా ఏంటంటే ఎల్డర్లీ పీపులే ఎక్కువ రిస్క్లో ఉన్నారు, వృద్ధులే ఎక్కువ రిస్క్లో ఉన్నారు అందరికన్నా కూడా. సో దే హ్యావ్ మోర్ అట్ రిస్క్ ఆఫ్ మోర్టాలిటీ, ఎక్కువ చనిపోయే ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కూడా వాళ్ళకి ఎక్కువ ఉంటాయి అని చెప్పడం వల్ల తీవ్రమైన ఆందోళన ఎక్కువ అయిపోతుంది అనమాట. మేము చూసిన చాలా మంది పేషెంట్స్లో కూడా ఈ సింటమ్స్ ఈ అంటే ఇలాంటి ఆలోచనలే మాకు చెప్తున్నారనమాట. సో ఏం చేయొచ్చు వీళ్ళకి అసలు, ఇంకా వీళ్ళలో స్ట్రెంగ్స్ ఏమి ఉన్నాయి, ఇది ఒకటి ఫస్ట్ టైం చూస్తున్నారా లేకపోతే వీళ్ళకి ఏమైనా స్ట్రెంగ్స్ కూడా ఉన్నాయా అంటే వృద్ధులకి చాలా వాళ్ళకి చాలా ఆసక్తికరమైన స్ట్రెంగ్స్ కూడా ఉన్నాయి. ఒకటి వాళ్ళు ఇలాంటి ఛాలెంజెస్ చాలా ఫేస్ చేస్తుంటారు ఇంతకుముందు, ఇంత పెద్దది కాకపోయినా వాళ్ళు ఒక పాండమిక్స్ కానీ ఎపిడమిక్స్ కాకపోయినా చిన్న చిన్న స్ట్రెస్సెస్ వాళ్ళు లోకల్ రేంజ్ స్ట్రెస్ అని ఫేస్ చేసి ఉంటారు, వాళ్ళు ఎలా బయటికి రావాలో వాళ్ళకి బాగా తెలుసు. సో ఒక రెజిలియన్స్ అంటాం ఇది, అంటే ఎంతవరకు ఆ ఈ స్ట్రెస్ని వాళ్ళు బేర్ చేయగలరు అనేది చాలా మందిలో మనం చూడాలి. ఈ రెజిలియన్స్ మనం పెంపొందించగలిగితే ఈ టైంలో దే కెన్ సేఫ్లీ కెన్ ఓవర్కమ్ దిస్ పాండమిక్. సో హౌ కెన్ వీ ఎన్హాన్స్ ద రెజిలియన్స్, అంటే ఈ రెజిలియన్స్ అనే దాన్ని మనం ఎట్లా మనం పెంపొందించవచ్చు వీళ్ళల్లో. ఒకటి వాళ్ళకి యాక్యురేట్గా ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఇవ్వడం. ఈ కోవిడ్ పాండమిక్ అనేది మోర్టాలిటీ అనేది లెస్ దాన్ ఒకప్పుడు 2-3% ఉండేది, ఇప్పుడు less than 2%, ఇట్ ఈస్ మచ్ లెస్సర్. అంటే మన వృద్ధి చెందిన దేశాలతో పోలిస్తే ఇది చాలా తక్కువ. సో 98% పీపుల్ రికవర్ అవుతున్నారు. సో మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద ఎల్డర్లీ ఆల్సో విల్ రికవర్ ఇఫ్ ఈవెన్ దర్ ఎక్స్పోజ్డ్ టు, వాళ్ళకి కోవిడ్ అనే ప్రాబ్లం వచ్చినా కూడా రికవర్ అవుతారు వాళ్ళు. ఇది ఫస్ట్ గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాలి. సో ఏమవుతుంది అసలు కోవిడ్ వస్తే అంటే సింటమ్స్ ఆర్ దే సింటమ్స్ లక్షణాలు ఉంటే హాస్పిటల్కి వెళ్తారు, లేదంటే హోమ్ కేర్ తీసుకుంటారు. హోమ్ కేర్లో ఎలాంటి ఐసోలేషన్ పాటించాలో క్లియర్ గైడ్ లైన్స్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఇవ్వగలిగితే వాళ్ళ యాంగ్జైటీ వాళ్ళ నర్వస్నెస్ కొంతవరకు తగ్గుతుంది. ఇది అక్యురేట్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఇవ్వాలి. ఇంకో ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఏంటంటే వాళ్ళ ఎసెన్షియల్ కమోడిటీస్ రీచ్ అవుతున్నాయా లేదని మేజర్ కన్సర్న్ వాళ్ళకి. అవి ఈటబుల్స్ కావచ్చు, వాళ్ళ మెడిసిన్స్ కావచ్చు, ఎసెన్షియల్ కమోడిటీస్ వాళ్ళకి అవైలబుల్గా ఉన్నాయా లేదా అని. ఇది మనం ఎన్షూర్ చేయగలిగితే హెల్ప్ లైన్స్ పెట్టేసి దిస్ కెన్ ఆల్సో రిడ్యూస్ అర్ యాంగ్జైటీ. ద థర్డ్ ఈజ్ ద రెగ్యులర్ మెడికల్ కేర్. అది హైపర్ టెన్షన్ కావచ్చు, డయాబెటీస్ కావచ్చు, వాళ్ళ రొటీన్ కేర్ కావచ్చు. ఇఫ్ దీస్ ఆర్ కెన్ బి మేనేజ్డ్, అంటే వాళ్ళ హాస్పిటల్ రాకుండా టెలికన్సల్టేషన్ ద్వారా చేయగలిగితే వాళ్ళ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద నీడ్స్ మనం కేర్ చేసినట్టే. సో ఇది మెంటల్ హెల్త్కి, మెంటల్ హెల్త్ రిగార్డింగ్ మెంటల్ హెల్త్ అంటే మనం మానసిక ఆరోగ్యం కోసం ఏం చేయొచ్చు ఈ టైంలో. సో హౌ టు ఓవర్కమ్ బోర్డమ్, హౌ టు ఓవర్కమ్ స్ట్రెస్, హౌ టు ఓవర్కమ్ అన్సర్టానిటీస్ అంటే, సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఈ టైం ద టైం మీరు మీరున్న స్పెండ్ చేస్తున్న టైం పిల్లలతో కావచ్చు, గ్రాండ్ చిల్డ్రన్తో కావచ్చు, మునిమనులతో కావచ్చు. ఇది టైం మళ్ళీ మీకు రాకపోవచ్చు ఫ్యూచర్లో. సో ఇలాంటి సిచ్యువేషన్ వేర్ ఎవ్రీబడి అందరూ ఇంట్లో ఉండడం మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద టైం. సో మీరు వాళ్ళతో క్వాలిటీ టైం, మీరు మీరు మాస్క్ వేర్ చేస్తూనే హ్యాండ్ వాషింగ్ పాటిస్తూనే వాళ్ళతో టైం స్పెండ్ చేయడం ఎలా అనేది మీరు మీరు చేయగలిగితే ఇట్ ఇస్ వండర్ఫుల్. ఇంకేంటంటే మీరు చాలా మటుకు చేసి ఉండరు చాలా పనులు ప్రీవియస్లో, అంటే మీ పాస్ట్లో. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఒక ఆల్బమ్స్ చూడము, మీ ఏదైనా మీ ఫంక్షనల్ వీడియోస్ చూడము, రీవిజిటింగ్ దెమ్ అంటాం మళ్ళీ, సో రిమెంబరింగ్ దెమ్ మూమెంట్స్ అంటాం అగైన్. అలాంటివన్నీ చేయగలిగితే ఐ థింక్ బోర్డమ్ని చాలా మటుకు మీరు పక్కన పెట్టేయచ్చు. అలాంగ్ విత్ దట్ మీకున్న వరీస్ కావచ్చు, మీరు అంటే రాయగలిగిన వాళ్ళు రాయొచ్చు, చెప్పగలిగిన వాళ్ళు దే కెన్ టెల్ టు పీపుల్ దే దే రిలేటివ్స్ చెప్పొచ్చు. సో ఇవన్నీ చేయగలిగితే కూడా వాళ్ళ వరీస్ ఏంటో అవన్నీ స్లోగా మనం డీల్ చేయొచ్చు వన్ బై వన్. ఇంకొకటి ఏంటంటే కొంతమందికి రాయడం ఇష్టము, కొంతమందికి పెయింటింగ్ చేయడం ఇష్టము, కొంతమందికి ఏంటంటే నిట్టింగ్ చేయడం అంటాం, నిట్టింగ్ అనేది ఇష్టం ఉంటుంది. సో ఇవన్నీ మనం ప్రొవైడ్ చేయగలిగితే ఐ థింక్ ఇట్ విల్ బి ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏ ఐ మీన్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద థింగ్స్ విచ్ కెన్ స్ట్రెస్ లెవెల్స్ తగ్గించగలుగుతాయి అనమాట. మెజారిటీ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ వాళ్ళకి వాళ్ళ ప్రాబ్లం ఏంటంటే వాళ్ళ బంధువులకైనా అవుతుందేమో తెలియదు, వాళ్ళ పిల్లలకైనా అవుతుందేమో అనేది వాళ్ళ వరీ ఉంటుంది. మనం ఇది దే వాంట్ కనెక్ట్ టు ద పీపుల్. సో మనం ఒక వీడియో కాల్ చేయించడం కానీ వాళ్ళు హెల్ప్ చేయడం హౌ టు కనెక్ట్ టు దట్ వీడియో కాల్ కానీ చేయగలిగితే అది కూడా కొంతవరకు మనకు హెల్ప్ అవుతుంది. ఇంకేం ఫిజికల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ ఏం చేయొచ్చు, చాలామందికి మేము ఏం అడ్వైస్ చేస్తున్నామంటే ఒక డేలో అట్లీస్ట్ 45 minutes ఆఫ్ ఫిజికల్ యాక్టివిటీ పెట్టుకోండి. ఇఫ్ దే కెనాట్ గో అవుట్ ఇన్ టు ద పార్క్, దే కెనాట్ గో అవుట్ ఆన్ టు ద డైలీ ప్లేసెస్ వేర్ దే కెన్ వాక్, వాళ్ళు టెర్రస్లో వాక్ చేయొచ్చు. దే కెన్ వాక్ అరౌండ్ ఇన్ ద లాన్, గార్డెన్ ఉంటే లాన్లో వాక్ చేయండి, టెర్రస్లో వాక్ చేయొచ్చు. ఇట్ నీ నాట్ బి కంబైన్డ్ యాక్టివిటీ అండి. కాకపోతే ఏంటంటే వాళ్ళు దే కెన్ మెయింటైన్ సోషల్ డిస్టెన్స్ అండ్ దే కెన్ స్టిల్ గో ఇన్ 1 or 2 people అలా వెళ్ళొచ్చు అనమాట. సో ఇలా చేయొచ్చు. స్లీప్ కోసం కూడా మేము ఏం చెప్తున్నామంటే వెన్ యూ థింక్ దట్ ఇస్ వరీ అవుతుంది అనుకోండి, మీరు నిద్ర రావట్లేదు అనుకోండి, ఒక నావెల్ చదవండి, ఏదంటే లేదా పాస్ట్ ఏదైనా డిస్కస్ చేయండి, లేకపోతే ఏదైనా ఒక వీడియో చూడండి మీ రిలేటివ్స్ గురించి కానీ ఫొటోస్ కానీ చూడండి. ఆ తర్వాత మీరు మీరు రిలాక్స్ అయినప్పుడు యూ కెన్ గో టు స్లీప్. ఇవన్నీ కూడా కొంతవరకు హెల్ప్ చేస్తాయి. ఇన్ సమ్ పీపుల్ అంటే వాళ్ళకి ప్రతిరోజు బేజారుగా ఉంటుంది, ప్రతిరోజు నర్వస్గా ఉంటుంది, ప్రతిరోజు నిద్రే రావట్లేదు, టెన్షన్ ఎక్కువగా అయిపోతూ ఉంది, ఆకలే వేయట్లేదు, ఇలా ఉందనుకోండి, ఇట్ ఈస్ బెటర్ దట్ వాళ్ళు ఒక మెంటల్ హెల్త్ ప్రొఫెషనల్, అది ఎవరినో కావచ్చు, ఫస్ట్ లెవెల్లో కౌన్సిలర్ కావచ్చు అప్రోచ్ అయితే మంచిది. వాళ్ళ దగ్గర నుంచి వాళ్ళ సివియరిటీని బట్టి దే కెన్ రెఫర్ టు ద సైకియాట్రిస్ట్ అని చెప్పుకోవచ్చు మనం. ఇది కాకుండా పీపుల్ ఆల్రెడీ మెంటల్ ఇల్నెస్ ఉండి వాళ్ళు ట్రీట్మెంట్ తీసుకుంటున్నారు అనుకోండి, వాళ్ళకి మనం చేసినట్టు వాళ్ళకి మెడిసిన్స్ ఎన్ష్యూర్ దే ఆర్ రిసీవింగ్ మెడిసిన్స్ అన్నది మనం ఎన్ష్యూర్ చేసుకోవాలి. మెడిసిన్స్ లేకపోతే అట్ ఎర్లియస్ట్ ఫేజ్ యూ రీచ్ ఎ మెంటల్ ప్రొఫెషనల్ టు గెట్ ద మెడిసిన్స్ అండ్ కంటిన్యూ దట్ మెడిసిన్స్. వీళ్ళు ఎందుకంటే వీళ్ళకి స్ట్రెస్ లెవెల్స్ అనేవి దే కెన్ ట్రిగ్గర్ ఏ న్యూ ప్రాబ్లమ్, ఆ ఓల్డ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ని మళ్ళీ ఎగ్జాగరేట్ చేయొచ్చు. సో ఆ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ మనం తగ్గించుకోవడానికి మెడిసిన్స్ కంటిన్యూటీ చేయడము, ఆ స్ట్రెస్ లెవెల్ని తగ్గించుకోవడము అలా చేయొచ్చు. ఒకవేళ వాళ్ళ రిలేటివ్స్ ఏదైనా జరిగింది అనుకోండి, ఒక అంటువర్డ్ ఈవెంట్ అంటే ఒక డెత్ మోర్టాలిటీ జరిగింది, వాళ్ళ ఫ్రెండ్స్కి ఎవరికో చనిపోయారు అనుకోండి, దాని గురించి ఎలా చర్చించాలి, ఒక డీప్ బ్రీఫింగ్ అంటాం మనం, అంటే అసలు అబౌట్ ఆ ఇన్సిడెంట్ గురించి డీటెయిల్గా మాట్లాడము, ఆ ఎమోషన్స్ వాట్ ఆర్ ఎమోషన్స్ ఈ ఫెల్ట్ అబౌట్ ఇట్ అనేది అడగడము. సో అలా మనం చేయడం వల్ల డీబ్రీఫింగ్ అంటాం, అంటే వీ కెన్ స్లే ఒక వాట్ కుడ్ హ్యావ్ హ్యాపెండ్ ఎట్ దట్ టైమ్ అనేది ఒక క్లోజర్ దానికి పెట్టవచ్చు అనమాట. చాలా మంది గ్రీఫ్లో కూడా ఉంటారు ఇలాంటి స్టేజెస్లో. సో వాళ్ళకు కూడా ఒక గ్రీఫ్ మన గ్రీఫ్ స్టేజెస్ అంటాం, అంటే దుఃఖం వాళ్ళ చనిపోయినప్పుడు ఆ దుఃఖం గురించి అసలు ఎలా అటాచ్మెంట్ ఏంటి పర్సన్కి అతనితో, సో ఎలా జరిగింది ఈవెంట్ అనేది, సో ఎమోషన్స్ ఆయన ఎమోషన్స్ ఏమేమి అతను ఫెల్ట్ అయ్యాడు అవన్నీ డిస్కస్ చేయడం వల్ల ఈ బాధను కొంతవరకు మనం తగ్గించి దానికి ఒక క్లోజర్ అంటాం, అంటే దానికి ఒక ఎండ్ని ఇవ్వచ్చు అనమాట స్లోగా. సో ఇవన్నీ కొన్ని చేయొచ్చు అండి మనము. సో దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఫ్రమ్ మై సైడ్ అండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ అండి. ఇంకా ప్యానల్ డిస్కషన్లో మీరు ఎలాంటి క్వశ్చన్స్ వస్తే ఐఎమ్ హ్యాపీ టు ఆన్సర్ అండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ అండి మహమ్మద్ రఫ్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ డాక్టర్ శివశంకర్ రెడ్డి గారు. దెన్ థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ అబౌట్ యువర్ వెరీ గుడ్ కవరేజ్ ఆఫ్ పాయింట్స్ ఇన్ వర్రీస్ అండ్ హౌ టు కమ్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ స్ట్రెస్ అఫెక్టెడ్ పీపుల్ వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మెంటల్ ఆర్ ఫిజికల్ ఆర్ సైకలాజికల్ అండ్ అన్సర్టెనిటీ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఓవర్ కవరేజ్ ఆఫ్ మీడియా అబౌట్ ద నెగటివ్ సైడ్ ఆఫ్ ది పాండమిక్. So thank you sir, thank you very much. Now I request Srimati Krupa Swarupa Rani garu and she's a district welfare officer Medchal and Malkaziri district government of Telangana and madam joined in women and welfare department worker for the welfare of 0 to above 60 years and almost 34 years of service completed and currently working as a district welfare officer in Medchal Malkajgiri district and for the welfare of disabled and senior citizens department. She has received best employee award as a superintendent of children from chief minister of Telangana in 2006 sorry the chief minister of combined Andhra Pradesh in 2006. So I request Sarupa Rani garu and please give your views on this and share your experience.
Thank you sir. I thank Raja sir for giving me this opportunity to be participate in among all of you. Many are very well experienced and so many points Shivashankar garu almost covered, but as a part of our department what we have done during COVID time I would like to share. Here, as I am working in this disabled and senior citizens department in Medchal district, we have many old age homes. About more than 69 old age homes are here. So we were very much worried about the COVID situations because if anything happens in one home, it will be very difficult to cope up with everybody about the press and all. So we have. Time to time we have given precautions, measurements, everything, awareness we have given to all the old age homes people, and we have made ensure that all the precautions, distance, like sanitizations, everything we made ensure. And personally we have visited all the homes with our staff like CDPOs, supervisors, and during this COVID period, and we have taken all the data from old age homes. In this we were very much worried about the COVID situations, how if anybody gets a COVID so ee situations lo maaku ee court పిల్లు కూడా ఒకటి పడింది. ఓల్డ్ ఏజ్ హోమ్స్లో చాలామంది ఫెసిలిటీస్ లేవనేసి తర్వాత వాళ్ళకి ఏ విధమైన సరిగా లేవు అనేసి వచ్చింది. దానివల్ల మేము ప్రతి హోమ్ కూడా విజిట్ చేసాము. విజిట్ చేసి అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టేకెన్ ఆల్ ద ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్, బట్ వాళ్ళకి కూడా అంటే ఈ సిచ్యుయేషన్లో కొంతమందికి మేము డిపార్ట్మెంట్ నుంచి వీ హ్యావ్ గివెన్ శానిటైజర్స్ అండ్ మాస్క్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ అండ్ అవేర్నెస్ కూడా ఇచ్చి మేము చూసామండి. అండ్ యూజువల్గా నేను డిజేబుల్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్లో ఉన్నప్పుడు చాలామంది అక్కడక్కడ పాపం హెల్ప్లెస్ కండిషన్లో బయట వాళ్ళు ఉన్నారు, ఎవరు చూస్తే వాళ్ళు లేక అలాంటి టైంలో చాలామందికి రెస్క్యూ చేసి మేము హోమ్స్లో మేము పెట్టాము. ఇటువంటి సిచ్యుయేషన్ అంతా అసలు ఓల్డ్ పీపుల్ ఓల్డ్ ఏజ్ టైంలో పిల్లల బాధ్యత ఉంటుంది, వాళ్ళు చూడక అంటే వాళ్ళని కేర్ చేయకపోతే పెద్దవాళ్ళకి చాలా సైకలాజికల్గా మెంటల్గా చాలా స్ట్రెస్ ఉంటుంది. వాళ్ళు అలా బయటికి రావడము, ఎవరు కేర్ లేకుండా ఉండడంతో ఇట్లాంటి వాళ్ళని ఓల్డ్ ఏజ్ హోమ్స్లో మేము పెట్టాము. యాక్చువల్గా ఇది ఈ సిచ్యుయేషన్స్ అన్నీ కూడా ఫ్యామిలీ ఈజ్ ద బెస్ట్ సపోర్ట్ ఐ కెన్ సే. ఫ్యామిలీలో ప్రతి ఒక్కళ్ళ బాధ్యత ఉండాలి, వాళ్ళు ఇది ప్రతి ఒక్క రెస్పాన్సిబుల్. ఎందుకంటే ఇప్పుడు వాళ్ళు పిల్లలు తల్లులు పెంచి పిల్లలు పెద్దగా చేసిన తర్వాత వాళ్ళని చూసుకోవాలనే బాధ్యత పిల్లలకు ఉంటుంది. వాళ్ళని వాళ్ళకి కొన్ని ఉన్న ఇమోషన్స్ కానీ ఏదైనా చిన్న ఇవి ఉంటే కూడా దే షుడ్ అట్లీస్ట్ స్పెండ్ సమ్ టైమ్, అట్లీస్ట్ 10 to 15 minutes, అట్లీస్ట్ 1/2 hour దే ఫీల్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ. ఎందుకంటే అట్లా రిజెక్టెడ్గా అయిపోతారు వాళ్ళందరూ. వాళ్ళ కోసం స్పెండ్ చేసే టైం చాలా మందికి ఇప్పుడు రోజులో ఉండటం లేదు. ఈ కోవిడ్ సిచ్యుయేషన్లో అయితే మటుకు అందరు ఫ్యామిలీ అందరు ఒక దగ్గర ఉంటున్నారు, కానీ వాళ్ళతో కూడా స్పెండ్ చేసి వాళ్ళకున్న ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కానీ మెడికల్ హెల్త్ కానీ మెంటల్ హెల్త్ కానీ వాళ్ళకున్న వాళ్ళకి సపోర్ట్ చేస్తే చాలా బాగుంటుంది. చాలా మందికి ఒక ఏజ్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత హీరింగ్ ప్రాబ్లం ఉంటుంది. దానివలన వాళ్ళు అనుకుంటారు వాళ్ళని వాళ్ళతో మాట్లాడడానికి కష్టమే, చాలా మంది మాట్లాడుకుంటూ ఉంటారు. సో వాళ్ళకి ఒక సపోర్ట్ లాగా ఉండి మాట్లాడితే వీఆర్ సపోర్టింగ్ యూ అనేసి వాళ్ళు కొంచెం ఎమోషనల్ స్ట్రెస్కి అన్నిటికీ వాళ్ళకి సపోర్ట్ చేస్తే ఓల్డ్ ఏజ్లో వాళ్ళు ఫీల్ అవ్వడము లోన్లీనెస్ ఫీల్ అవ్వడం అవన్నీ ఉండవు. సో ఇదంతా మెయిన్ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఫ్యామిలీ అండి. ఫ్యామిలీ సపోర్ట్ ఉండాలి కంపల్సరీగా. లేని వాళ్ళే ఇలా ఓల్డ్ ఏజ్ హోమ్స్లోను తర్వాత వీధుల్లోనూ ఉంటారు. ఇలాంటివి లేకుండా ఉండాలంటే ప్రతి ఒక్కళ్ళను ఒక అవేర్నెస్ అబౌట్ ఓల్డ్ పీపుల్ వాళ్ళకుండే ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ చూసుకోవాలి. తర్వాత చాలామంది లైక్ ఈ పిల్లలు వాళ్ళ దగ్గర ఉన్న డబ్బులు ఆస్తి అవన్నీ తీసేసుకొని వాళ్ళని చూడకుండా ఉండడం ప్రాబ్లం చేయడము. సో వాళ్ళు సైకలాజికల్గా చాలా ఎఫెక్ట్ అయ్యి వాళ్ళు ఇంకా డిప్రెషన్లోకి వెళ్ళిపోవడం ఇవన్నీ జరుగుతున్నాయి. సో ఇవన్నీ జరగ అండ్ దీనికి హెల్పేజ్ ఇండియా నుంచి కూడా చాలా కౌన్సిలింగ్ నేను వాళ్ళ హెల్ప్ కూడా తీసుకున్నాను. వాళ్ళు కూడా చాలా మటుకు మాకు చాలా మందికి కౌన్సిలింగ్ చేశారు. ఐఎమ్ వెరీ థ్యాంక్ఫుల్ టు దెమ్. ఇట్లాంటి హెల్పేజెస్ లైక్ వాళ్ళలాగా అన్ని చాలా ఉండాలని సెంటర్స్, సో దట్ వాళ్ళకి ఇమీడియట్గా ఏదైనా హెల్ప్ ఉన్నా వెంటనే రీచ్ అవ్వడానికి ఇట్ విల్ బి వెరీ వెరీ హెల్ప్ఫుల్. అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ మై పార్ట్ ఓన్లీ. థ్యాంక్ యూ. ఐ థ్యాంక్ యూ వన్స్ అగైన్ ఫర్ గివింగ్ మీ దిస్ ఆపర్చునిటీ. థ్యాంక్ యూ
sharing of your experience and what exactly going in Telangana and how the government of Telangana is taking care of the elderly in the old age homes. And now I request AVD Narayan Rao Garu, because Narayan Rao Garu is the assistant director in Krishna district welfare of differently abled and transgender and senior citizens, government of Andhra Pradesh. And Mr. Rao is a postgraduate in social work from Andhra University in 1981-1983 and joined in the services in 1988 in the District Rehabilitation Center in Vijayawada and the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment of Government of India. In the field of rehabilitation, persons with disabilities in the year 2011, he has been posted as an assistant director welfare of disabled and senior citizens Adilabad district and worked 3 years for a period of 4 years from 2011 to 2015. In the state reorganization, assistant director has been allocated in Andhra Pradesh and he was posted as a assistant director welfare disabled and senior citizens Krishna district. During his period of services in United Andhra Pradesh, he has been awarded state award for the services rendered in implementation of Senior Citizens Act for the welfare of senior citizens in 2013 and received meritorious award from the district collector in Nalgonda, Adilabad and Krishna district for his services. And he has got wide and vast experience. And Mr. Narayan Rao Garu, please share your suggestions and views on healthy aging and during this COVID pandemic.
Yeah, now I'm good morning to all of you, sir.
Good morning.
This is am I audible, sir?
Yeah, audible.
Yeah, am I audible, sir? Is it?
Yes, audible.
Okay, thank you. This is Narayan Rao, and we are all aware that this COVID-19 has spread to over India, mostly in the month of March. And right from March, we are all striving hard to prevent the spread of this COVID-19 For the past 6 months, we are doing it. And I'm also involved in this COVID-19 activities as a special officer for these quarantine centers. And I was also appointed for a COVID care center in Krishna district. And what my observation is that in this COVID-19, the pandemic situation, the most vulnerable people in the society is the elderly people, at the same time the children less than 14 years people, between 5 to 14 years people. And with regards to senior citizens, we have requested to all the senior citizens associations, as well as the old age homes, chief functionaries, and wherever they are right now in their institutions or at the homes, should be very careful. We have given proper instructions, SOP, standard operating procedures being followed by the government, have been communicated to all the elderly people in our district. And at the same time, our association people also are actively involved, and they have been sent to the various non-governmental organizations running these old age homes to take care of their health, mostly their health, as well as maintaining social distancing and using of masks and sanitizers and everything properly being monitored by our departments besides our senior citizens association. At the same time, from our government sector also, from our government, our district collector has taken initiation, and we have supplied ration to all the older persons living in the old age homes by at the rate of 10 kgs rice per individual per month, and chana also got distributed. And with regards to this COVID test, most of the people, they are afraid of this test, where to go and how to approach and all those things. In these circumstances, we have taken an initiation, and we have taken permission from the district collector to send buses to all the non-governmental organizations running these old age homes and conducting a COVID test to everyone in that old age home. There are about 31 old age homes in the district, and we are sending buses, and we are getting results also. At the same time, the one more thing, initiation, what we have done in Krishna district is appointing of psychologists, those who did their master's degree in psychology or MSc or testing, and PhDs are also there. We have appointed them a team of psychologists. We are deputing them to the COVID care centers as well as quarantine centers, and we are planning to now to send to the old age homes also to take care of their mental health of the senior citizens, because the services, the most of the COVID-19 deaths are caused by senior citizens. So in this context, we are planning to send our psychologist teams to the old age homes for giving proper counseling and guidance to the senior citizens about the COVID-19 and care should be taken about the COVID-19. With these innovations, now the Krishna district is standing. Cases reporting is the lowest number in India. About the 130 like that, we are noticing this number among other districts and states. And besides this, We are also, we are, our senior citizens associations are actively involved, and we have collected some amount of about 25,000 donation to the COVID cause to the district collector, and we are conducting health camps with the help of senior citizens in the district by distributing medicines and everything to the senior citizens in the district. That's what from my Krishna district I am doing. That's all, sir. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Narayan Rao, sir. Thank you very much. Now, really that state government of Andhra Pradesh is going forward to do the best, and I think it is highest in conducting the test and other things. So you have 31 old age homes and sending psychologist and to enhance the courage level and to the elderly in the old age homes. Thank you. And now the hour of question and answers now, and I request the attendees, if they have any questions, they can pose the questions, and we will be able to respond. And you can ask the question whom you directly want to answer the question. We have received only 4 questions, but that is regarding photo is not there, sound system is not, and the language problem. These are the 4 questions has been asked from the attendees. So now I request our Dr. Ritu Rana Madam to give a conclusion about our webinar today. And Madam, unmute yourself.
Yes, Raja. Yeah. I lost you. Please, you can you come once again?
Actually, this is a question and answers, but we have received only 4 questions. Okay. But not related to the topic. It is related to the sound, and somebody says that language problem, and someone says that no, resounding such things. So I don't think if Shyam, is there any person who want to clarify their doubt or questions?
So thank you, sir. No, sir. Actually, all the topics they have already covered. So and Srinivas Shivashankar sir has explained excellent in Telugu language, and also Sojan Anthony sir, and at the same time Shivakumar sir and Thirumurthy sir also. So thank you very much. But last week I have received a call from one senior citizen, elderly person. His age is 80 years. So, and also he's a handicapped. So he has told me he's infected a corona, and he has get the corona successfully. But people are very fearing this situation whenever this corona. So most of the people they're like a stress, and they're feeling very psychological problems. But I'm telling, no, nothing is to happen. So I'm the 80 years old Shyam, sharing with our senior citizens. So I have infected the corona with my son. So from my son I have infected this corona only, and have get home treatment only. I have taken the home treatment, and I have overthrown the corona. So he's after he is speaking with him, sir, I am also feeling very happy, because don't feel that almost 100 years above elders also successfully they are getting out the corona. So it is a which Shivashankar sir has told, and Anthony sir, Sojan Anthony sir has told, so same thing. So thank you very much. I think no question and answers are there, so thank you.
Okay, Raza, before we wind up, have one suggestion from each of the panelists here, and if they can suggest one thing, one key message that the older population should do to take care of their mental well-being and to the healthy aging during this pandemic. So I would request to give one key message from each of the panelists. We start with Dr. Shiva Shankar Reddy.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm the junior most here, but anyway, I think one key message would be, this is not going to be long-standing one. We are coming to a closure of it slowly, gradually. So my key message would be that have a structured activity. Continue your passion, whatever you have. In a way, it is possible it can be done at home. Whatever passions, hobbies, try to do at your home, in your vicinity itself. If you continue that, maintain good sleep, adequate nutrition, you will overcome all these things. This is my message.
Thank you. And
I think I am the next person available here. So I just wanted to tell everybody, in India, we used to have more deaths compared to this due to the infection among various sections of the population. So this media is also giving a lot of attention, a lot of news is coming, a lot of discussions are happening. I recommend senior citizens to not to watch these kind of arguments and marketing events. I won't call it as a news. It's a more of marketing events. Let's not focus on these marketing events. You continue your life. That's the message. You continue your life. Don't focus on these marketing events, which happens during 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, or news business. And if you need any information, definitely you can visit the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare website. And authentic information like HelpAge India and all will be sharing a senior citizen friendly messages. A focus some channel where you get senior citizen friendly messages, not through these television channel discussions, which is not going to solve any of our problems. It is simply it's a marketing event. Thank you.
Madam, I just want to share this thing because it's really a good news that the death rate has come down almost to 1.9%. And another important thing is the recovery rate among the COVID patient improved a lot. That is now 25.19%. When you compare 14 days back, it was only 13%. That means the virus the capacity and the power of the virus is coming down. This we can note it. Thank you.
Madam Sarupa. Madam, unmute yourself.
Yes, madam. Actually, to finally, we have to keep ourselves healthy and comfortable as far as possible. It is silent struggle with an unknown enemy. So we have to walk with the COVID situations. So firstly, when we know that this COVID is very dangerous like that, everybody got panicked. Now we are getting on well with the situations. So like that, we should be very comfortable and we should be happy like that. This is my message. Thank you.
Do we have Dr. Shiva Kumar here? Because I'm seeing him as a connected, but I don't know whether he's available or not.
Dr. Shukumar is not there.
Okay. And do we have Shri Narayan Rao here with us?
Shyam?
Sir, yes, sir.
Dr. Narayan Rao is there?
Actually, he's there. Sir. He's there, yeah. Yes, sir.
Dr. Narayan Rao Garu? Can you hear us?
Yeah, he's there. I think some internet problems are while his presentation also some problem.
Madam, your final.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, all the panelists, and your deliberations were really very eye opening and very useful for all of us. Not only for the older generation, but everyone. has got something to learn, and we should practice from now onwards to live the healthy aging, because we all are heading towards the aging, right? So I would like to say only one thing, that during this pandemic and years after that, we should not be looking at the disconnecting, we say the social distancing or the physical distancing. So we should not make it as a disconnect. We should try to make as much as possible connectivity with our parents, with our elder generation. So the connectivity should be the key message. So in whatever way you can connect with them, you can communicate with them, give them a word of compassion and love and care, then ultimately everyone would be having a peaceful life and would lead towards a healthy age. That's the only the key message I would like to have.
Thank you. And Dr. Sojan, thank you so much for your coordination to make this webinar is a successful this thing, and I'm sure that HelpAge India definitely worked with NIMHANS, and we can take it to the elderly in different states, and in the future we work together, and that is very much this thing, and government of Telangana, government of Andhra Pradesh, and with NIMHANS and HelpAge and senior citizen associations in both the states. So with this, I request Shyam Kumar to present vote of thanks, and we are right in time, another 7 minutes in there.
Yeah, so thank you, sir. Thank you very much. So thank you very much, madam, Ritu madam, and so given for participating in the webinar. And thank you, especially Sojan sir. So whenever I speak with my friend, so immediately he has agree and kind of going to very interested to organize this webinar, and also participated 4 staff from there, even Shivakumar sir. Actually he is a professor and department head and social psychiatry, and thank you Thirumurthy sir, PhD. He's did a PhD, he's a professor and psychiatric social work. And thank you Shivashankar Reddy sir, thank you very much, so for participating. And thank you very much for Swaruparani madam. Actually today some program is pilot project is going to start today itself. Already in Madchal, government of Telangana is going to start from today only, but at the very busy schedule she came and she has given time. And Narayan Rao sir also, so in the corona situations government people they are very busy, but they are given some they're spending their valuable time to the HelpAge India, and especially for the case of senior citizens or elderly people. And thank you very much Raza Muhammad sir has coordinated this to organize this webinar for the our two states. So thank you very much. Thank you, and a special thanks to our community communication team and our IT team, Vishnu sir, and also Sonali madam and Anupama madam, and all our HelpAge India head office people, and here in our Telugu states, especially in SPOs, all the SPOs, and our Stanley sir. So everyone, thank you very much.
Yeah, one word of thanks from NIMHANS. On behalf of NIMHANS team, we thank HelpAge India for this organizing this wonderful program, including Dr. Ritu Rana ma'am. In spite of her busy schedule, no, she has come, and we are looking forward to meaningful collaborations with HelpAge India. And already, you know, we have some programs in pipeline. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you,
sir, and thank you all other.
Thank you.